This technique will help you with Chapter 1, Exercise 3, Creating a Dynamic Composition. It helps to see the painting you're basing your composition on while you work. You can place a reference image into Illustrator and create a template to draw on top of. Here's how. When you begin Exercise 3, you'll see a hyperlink to a photo on Flickr. Click it. On Flickr, look for an All Sizes option above the image and click it. A page will open with a large version of the image showing. To download this image, right-click on it and select the option to save it. I'm using the Firefox web browser. Different browsers may have different menu wording. Look at the file name and make sure you know where you're saving the image. I'll save mine to my Documents folder. I'm using the Command key plus the Tab key to switch to Illustrator, where I've already created a new print document as instructed in Exercise 2. From the menu bar, select File and choose the Place command. Navigate to the file you downloaded. You should see it if you're using column view. You'll get a preview. When you find the file, select it to highlight it and press the Place button. The image is placed right into your Illustrator document in the center. Now, to turn it into a template, you need to show the Layers panel. You can either go to the Window menu and choose Layers, or you can press the Layers button at the bottom of the right panel. Double-click on Layer 1 to access its options. Place a check mark next to the template option. You can see that changes some of the other options. And while you're here, rename the layer template just by typing. Naming your layers descriptively is a really good habit to develop. When you're finished, click OK. Changing the layer to a template locks the layer. See the lock icon? This means that you can't accidentally move or delete the reference artwork. You also can't draw on this layer. See how my pencil icon now has a line through it? And it dims the layer. The only thing you can really do with the layer at this point is show or hide it by toggling the template icon. Since the template layer is locked, you need to add a layer so that you can begin drawing your dynamic composition for Exercise 3. Click the flyout menu on the Layers panel and choose New Layer. Give your layer a descriptive name and click OK. Now you're ready to start Exercise 3 with an image you can look at as you work to draw your rectangles. Good luck!